it passes in anyone else, but he gave the ball away there. Chris crosses to Bale, and Real Madrid take the lead. Only 8 minutes on the clock, and Bale marks his return with a goal from a Cruz cross, and it was Trazoras, the man who never gives the ball away, who lost possession in a very dangerous area. Real Madrid 1-0 up.
Well, that's why you just can't lose the ball in those kind of areas against Real Madrid, because they will punish you, and, well, they have punished Rayo Vallecano here. Gareth Bale celebrating with his trademarked heart celebration. It was all about the cross, really. He could miss, Gareth Bale. Cristiano Ronaldo, no question about offsides for cross, and it's a lovely ball across the six-yard box. Perfect for Gareth Bale, who'd made an intelligent run. Got him behind the defenders, and all he had to do was slide the ball home.
And Toni Kroos, whose job really in this team is to play just in front of the defence, popping up on the right, on the left-hand side with the assist for the goal.
Yeah, and the thing is, it doesn't even really surprise you, does it, to see either Kroos or... Speaking of good records against Rayo, Cristiano Ronaldo scored 8 in his last 6 games against Rayo Vallecano.
Second corner of the game for Real Madrid. In swinging, one, and it's 2-0, and it's Sergio Ramos who's got the goal. The corner from James Rodriguez and the header from that man Ramos, and this time Christian Alvarez could get nowhere near that. And Real Madrid double their lead 5 minutes before half time. Just what Paco Gemez would have not wanted to happen.
Yeah, disastrous for Rayo Vallecano. They've been playing well since the first goal, enjoying a lot of possession, passing the ball around nicely, and even creating a couple of opportunities of their own. It's a strange goal, isn't it? Comes off his knee.
Well, the view from behind the goal, it looks as if Benzema's trying to... In fact, it's Pepe. It looks as if Pepe's trying to clear it, but Pepe doesn't get to it, and Ramos is able to turn it in. Those two often go for the same ball at corners, and Ramos in particular is often guilty of... And he's not a regular starter. You get the feeling that Paco Gemez, a bit like his, shall we say, role model Pep Guardiola, doesn't really favour a big centre forward, but would rather play with almost a converted midfielder, Baptista, almost a false nine really for Rayo. But they do call upon him late in games when they need to change things. And if Pepe's a bit dazed and confused, then Manucho will be the last thing he wants to see and the last thing he wants to have to come up against in the second half.
Back on his feet now, Pepe. There you see Carlo Ancelotti scratching his chin.
Pepe's going to need some staples, I think.
Yeah, looks really lining up in the six-yard box to tuck it home. Unselfish play from Cristiano Ronaldo. And that is a bitter pill to swallow for Rayo Vallecano, who started this second half very well indeed, and now it's all over, really. Real Madrid lead 4-1.
And Pepe, of all people, who's the man who starts the move. I think Benzema may well be in an offside position. The hands are up, the flag, unfortunately for Rayo, isn't, though. So Castro's appeals in vain.
I tell you what, he's a mile offside, isn't he?
Yeah.
Unless there's a fullback that we haven't seen in that repetition, he looks like an absolute mile offside, Karim Benzema. More punishment for Rayo Vallecano.
At the moment, I'm sure, to see if they've got away with that, Real Madrid.
Play waved on by the referee, intelligently so. Real Madrid certainly could get advantage from this move, and they do! It's Toni Kroos with a beauty from outside of the box. There was hardly any backlift from the Germany international. He just tucked it into the corner. A wonderful strike from Toni Kroos. Leo Baptista thought he'd equalised. Real Madrid have got up the other end, and suddenly it's Real Madrid 3, Rayo Vallecano 1.
Well, the technique is absolutely fantastic. There's the offside decision previous and the handball as well from Sicastro. But he makes this look so easy, but it absolutely isn't. So difficult to keep down. We saw a similar chance earlier from Modric, and he failed to do so. And he just passes it into the corner. And it's almost like a bowling ball, the way it just bends in at the last moment. Absolutely fantastic goal. Pretty sure that's his first in the league in this stadium. And what a fantastic signing. And there are so many clubs around Europe thinking, why didn't we get Toni Kroos? Quite possibly, I suppose.
It comes back inside to Isco. Here is Cristiano Ronaldo. Still Ronaldo. Oh, it's gone in. It was a tame shot. You get the feeling that Christian Alvarez was expecting something a bit different by Ronaldo. So were the rest of us. It was a weak shot and gave in many respects. He's made some good saves, but that was a bit of a howler. And Ronaldo does get his name on the score sheet. It's another goal and another goal against Rayo Vallecano. That's 9-7 now against Rayo.
I'm not only we're going to see it on the replay, because the replay doesn't go back far enough, but it was absolutely brilliant from Benzema, because Benzema could see Ronaldo to his left, but Ronaldo was in his offside position, so he just managed to hold the ball up long enough. He kept possession, didn't release Ronaldo. And